Hi guys, it's Crystal with Design Bundles. Today I'm going to show you guys how to sublimate a felt puzzle. So this is a heart-shaped puzzle, which will be perfect for Valentine's. So my idea with this, you can sublimate on one side because both sides are sublimatable. You can put a photo on the back. You can break it in half. You're technically not breaking it, but taking it apart. Give one to one friend, keep one side, or give one to your husband, boyfriend, girlfriend, whichever way you guys want to do this, and give it to grandma, grandpa, however, and have the photos on the back, or you can simply just do the front, whichever way that you want to. So these are a ton of fun. And I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys really quickly. So it's gonna look just like this. So let's go ahead and get started. For today's project, this is the file that we're gonna be using. This is a super cute PNG. It's a Valentine's Day plaid leopard. Now you can use these for Christmas. There's tons of things that you can use these. Like for example, our football team is white and red. So this would be great to use for, you know, football season or anything like that. Cause you're gonna get all of these files right here. But the one that we're gonna be using today is gonna be the one that says Be Mine, but it's gonna come with the other ones as well. So that's really exciting. So you're gonna get more bang for your buck. So what you wanna do is go ahead and download this design. What I'm gonna do is come on over to Sawgrass Creative Studio and I'm gonna upload it. So I wanna come down to Galleries, My Image, Upload an Image, Upload Image. Click on it here, choose for upload. And at this point, you can rename it if you'd like. I'm gonna hit save. All right, so now that I have it downloaded, what I'm gonna do is come to custom canvas. So what you wanna do is measure how big your project is. So I've actually measured the entire piece of felt, not just the heart, but the entire piece, and it is 8 1/4 by 8 1/4. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna give me that quarter all the way around of a bleed line. That way I know that I'm fully protected and I'm not gonna miss a spot. So what I'm gonna do is change the units to inch, and I'm gonna type by 8 1/2. All right, we're gonna hit create. Now I know whatever I put into this right here is gonna be 8 1/2 by 8 1/2. So we're gonna go to Galleries, My Images. We're gonna click on it and bring it on in. All right, so now what we need to do is grab one of these black, squares here. Now keep in mind when you're using the custom canvas, these numbers over here do not matter. This is only when it comes to the custom canvas. Number one, you cannot save these, they won't save. And also these numbers right here do not matter. So I know that I've made it 8 1/2, it's gonna be 8 1/2, right? So what we need to do is expand this to cover that. So what I'm gonna do is something. So I wanna make sure I'm gonna have enough. So mine's gonna be a little bit like this. So I want it like that, right? I'm ready to go. Now I may end up with a little bit of white on my puzzle and I'm fine with that because this is like a distressed design. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit print. All right, so I've already got my printer selected. I'm gonna go ahead and choose US letter. I'm just gonna choose polyester. All right, so now that it's sent it over to the printer, everything is ready to go. I'm gonna go ahead and hit print. So here is the items that you're gonna need. So today we're using these felt puzzles here. I think they come in a 5-pack. You can get them over on Condi. There's a ton of places to buy blinks, but that's where I got mine. So it's this really cute puzzle you can see. We're actually just gonna sublimate the whole thing and then pop this piece out. So we've already printed our design that's gonna go right on top of that. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see the whole Be Mine, but you guys will get the point. For this project today, I'm actually using Condi's Pro Spray. That's just the brand that I've only ever known, but what we're gonna do is spray this on here, and that is what's going to hold it. So instead of using, you know, heat-resistant tape, we're actually gonna be using the Pro Spray to get that on there. So it's like a temporary adhesive is what it is. And you want a lint roller. Now this one right here is actually double-sided, so you could do both sides. So today we're just gonna be doing the one side with this, but for a Valentine's gift, it would be really cute to do, you know, your photo on the back. It would be really, really cute. Now to do the back, you're just gonna do them one at a time. You do the front, then you would flip it over and you would do the back. All right, so here we go. First thing we need to do is lint roll. You just wanna make sure that there's no little pieces of lint that's going to mess up our design, all right? Next thing that we're gonna do is you wanna take your Pro Spray here and you wanna lightly mist it onto your design. So we're gonna be real careful not to get it everywhere. I'm gonna hold it actually out of the camera so I don't get it on anything. So now what we're gonna do is, I'm actually gonna do it this way. So I'm gonna lay it down that way, and I'm gonna lay this so I can make sure I'm kind of getting it where I want it. Have a little bit more control. All right, so say I was happy with that. You're just gonna rub it down like that, and now it's attached. All right, so let's go ahead and take it over to the heat press. All right, so what I wanna do, you wanna get a cover sheet down here. You could use, you know, paper, whatever you want to. I'm gonna use parchment paper on the bottom. Definitely make sure you do, because you wanna protect your platen. And then I'm actually going to put this on here face up, so you have your puzzle, then you have your design. So we've got that face up. And then we're gonna put another piece of parchment paper to protect the top piece. Now this is 400 degrees for 60 seconds. We're gonna drop it down. Medium to light pressure. I'm actually gonna raise it up a little bit. There we go. So medium to light pressure on this. Now when you're sublimating, you really wanna use some heat gloves. I found these at Michael's. These are actually made for their mold press. These were like $7, plus you can use a coupon, so I highly recommend you get you a pair. You really want to be safe when it comes to sublimating because it gets super hot. So we're gonna remove that. Come back down to camera one so we can see what we got going on here. And we're just going to fill this up. You guys can see how nice that is. How cool is that, huh? So awesome, I love it. So what we're gonna do, so we're gonna leave a little bit of the M and a little bit of the E. We're just going to pop this out. Just like so. There you have it. How cute is that? And it's a puzzle, so that way you can put it together. There you have it. Now this is not real hot as other items can be, but just be safe and be mindful because, I mean, you did heat it up to 400 degrees. So you could take this apart like so. You could keep one, give one to your best friend. So that would be a great gift. It would be a great gift, you know, to give to a husband and wife. It's just really fun, grandma. But you can put the photos on the back so that way each photo is on each side. Does that make sense? I really love the way that this came out. This is a fun, easy project. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, please hit the like button down below and subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next one.